Hey you, why aren't you smiling? It's 1D day. The time has come, guys. A while ago, we put up a poll asking you where we should start in One Direction's discography.
Up All Night took the cake, but in hindsight, why not start with the one that started it all?
One Direction is one of the highest selling boy bands of all time. I have actually never heard a full One Direction album, but I've followed all of the guys.
Yeah, I've never listened to a full 1D album all the way through.
They've gone off to pursue their own careers. And I've followed those careers, but I never followed them as a band for some reason. I'm excited today to see what started it all.
Yeah.
You know, we're looking to get into some new artists on this channel, and One Direction has been one that's like, why not?
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Why not?
Honestly. Wasting no time, let's jump right into Up All Night.
You're insecure, don't know what for. You're turning heads when you walk through the door. Everyone else in the room can see it.
Yeah,
everyone else but you. Maybe you light up my world like nobody else. You don't know you're beautiful. If only you saw what I can see. That's what makes you beautiful.
Okay, can we turn it up?
Yes, we can.
So come on. You got it wrong. I don't know why.
I know this song.
You're being shy. You understand why I want you so desperately. Right now I'm looking at you and I can't believe you don't know. Oh, that's what makes you beautiful. Na 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 na. The way that you flip your hair gets me overwhelmed. But when you smile at the ground, it ain't hard to tell.
Arguably one of the most recognizable boy band tracks ever. Everyone knows that song.
The way that this song had a hold on everybody.
It feels timeless. Like, I don't feel like I'm listening to something from 2011, 2012.
For that to be a debut single, that was huge.
Huge. Now, I do want to talk about the meaning a little bit, because saying you don't know what makes you beautiful and that's what makes you beautiful, I think that sometimes you have people who know that they're attractive and it can kind of make them be a little arrogant.
Kind of a turn off.
A little cocky, and it can be a turn off. Yeah. So I think that when people are attractive, but don't act like they're attractive,
yeah,
it makes them attractive.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm not saying that they're acting insecure, because that's another thing.
Right.
It's just like, that's not their only personality trait. Being pretty, you know what I mean? Like, exactly. There are other things to them.
Yeah, I think it was a good message.
Great way to start the album.
And a good way to be introduced to the world,
mm-hmm.
and a great introduction to the album.
Definitely.
Girl, I see it in your eyes, you're disappointed with your heart. I tore it apart. And girl, what a mess I made upon your innocence. And no woman in the world deserves this. Can we fall?
Yeah. And it's the same layout. Liam and Harry.
If you walk away, it's gotta be you.
I know this song.
I like this one.
Now girl, I hear it in your voice and how it trembles. When you speak to me, I don't resemble who I was.
I like the rhyme scheme.
Enough,
me too.
I'll be here.
Like Niall came in too.
There is nobody else. It's gotta be you.
I love this great crescendo.
Only you. Can we try one more time? One more. Can we try one more? Cause it's gotta be you.
Oh. Oh, wow. I like she's up in back.
Yeah.
the strings in the back are accompanied by them saying, hey, 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 hey. So it's almost like they're
following that,
being the instrument, if that makes sense.
Yeah,
like
I
the instrumentation.
I like this.
Gotta be you.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
Ah. Going out with a bit of a...
What? Wow.
String moment again.
Yeah.
That was a bit of a pad, too. I call it
that
a pad.
That actually made me really hype. I mean, What Makes You Beautiful is an incredible song, but for that to be the second song, it almost feels like it would be the last. You add strings.
That's true. It feels like a big moment. Down.
The chorus is... I really like that song.
Uh-oh. Made the playlist?
Even the message, like, it's just such a...
It's gotta be you. I don't want nobody else.
Vulnerability, which I really like. Like, yeah. Listening to those lyrics, they're very vulnerable.
It's like just admitting your wrongs.
You're disappointed. It was me. You know, I let you down. But
the line that stuck out to me was, what a mess I made upon your innocence.
Yeah, and no.
That's
yeah,
like,
no
one whoa.
In the world deserves this.
But we're off to a positive start.
I really liked that song. That was good.
Oh. A hit.
Yes.
I can't ever be brave, 'cause you make my heart race.
Go on.
Shot me out of the sky. You're my kryptonite. Something's gotta give now.
Okay.
'Cause I'm dying just to make you sing. Get out, get out, get out of my head. I'm falling to my arms instead. You got that one thing.
Really forgot about this song.
Now
we get to hear some Niall. I like that.
The claps again.
That's one thing they did well in 2012 with the music.
Yeah.
The breakdowns
and
are amazing.
The bridge.
Yes, yes, amazing.
They're really being smart about how they pair each other up.
Yes, the voices complement.
And then I like how in these little pre-choruses, they're having Zayn continue to do like the back harmonies.
Get out, get out, get out of my head. I'm falling to my arms instead.
Trend I'm noticing, all three of these songs so far, starting with What Makes You Beautiful, they're talking about what makes this girl
special.
Like, there's something about her. She's got
her.
That one thing. It has to be her. And it's almost like saying she don't even know what it is.
Yeah.
It's all, like
she's unaware of the effect that she has on them.
Exactly.
Those songs, all topic-wise,
complement
each other very well. At first, I was like, man, like, do I remember this song? I know it. Mm-hmm. And then the minute we got to, like, the pre-chorus and it was building up, I was like, yeah.
No, I knew it off title. I just forgot, like, they do that little pause.
I need that one thing.
Not how it goes.
Even looking at the lyrics for the next song, I am noticing Liam is definitely...
He's leading with most
off,
verses.
Yeah, and I didn't realize that he led so much. So I'm excited to get into the next track, because one thing is... All three of those, actually, were our hits.
La hit.
No, I'm lying. I don't know.
I'm broken, 'cause you are everything I see. I'm dancing alone, and as I walk up to your door, my head turns to face the floor. When he opens his arms and holds you close tonight, it just won't feel
right.
That's it. More than this.
I didn't expect that since.
No, you gotta give me a minute. I'm getting excited. Now I'm getting excited. For Liam to switch his pitch too.
Actually, yeah, I really like the way he's saying that pre-chorus.
But that chorus, I know that second chorus is going to hit.
Because Niall is coming in really nice and strong.
Niall said, this is my moment.
Would you see me?
Yes.
Yeah, I like this.
You save me. When you leave, it's gone again. And then I see you on the street. In his arms, I can't wink. Praying. When he opens his arms.
And it lays it down, I might just die.
I've never had the words to say.
I know this part.
I'm asking you to stand. Pray that you will see the light. Yes. When he opens his arms and holds you close tonight. It just won't feel right. I can love you more than when he lays it down, I might just die.
Okay.
Wow.
That's my favorite so far.
I noticed listening. When you have the first three songs, like we said, they're kind of describing that special thing about the girl.
Right.
More than this strikes me as a type that they are observing her in another relationship.
Yes, and saying you deserve better.
Yeah, you deserve better. And because you have all these qualities,
right.
you're with, appreciating you
together.
The way that I would.
Yeah.
So more than this is beneficial to not only the story, but the album, because it was just so damn good.
Yes.
I want to highlight Niall's verse. That is my favorite, aside from the chorus. Vocally, because he, like we said, he took that moment, he took that opportunity.
Yeah.
His voice sounded so strong and rich on this song. You know, when you have a slow song in the beginning of your album, you really have to be careful of where you place it and really how to structure the song. And that was perfect because the synths added that pop influence.
For me, it was the synths and the deep hits. The deep hits for me is what makes it feel more pop than a ballad. There's a step to it. You know what I mean? Like there's a beat to it. So it's not like it's slowing down to where it could come across as almost a surprise or boring.
Yeah.
It's coming across like, okay, we're moving steady.
Yeah.
And now we're even speaking from a different perspective. That's the same, like it's in the same thread.
Yeah.
But now we're talking about another thing about this girl where it's like, because you're special, like you said,
you deserve more.
You deserve more.
Yeah.
It feels like we've been living in fast forward. Another moment passing by. The party's ending, but it's not.
Definitely 2011.
Katy Perry's on a play. She's on a play. I'm still wide awake. I wanna stay up.
Title tracks are very important.
Very important.
I think that was a good title track.
Okay, yeah. Here's how I feel about it, right? Obviously, we haven't heard the rest of the album, but the beginning of the album is very much love-based.
Yes.
It's very love-based in the beginning. So I was expecting the song Up All Night to be maybe about how she... thinking about her maybe is keeping them up all night.
That was my first thought.
That was my first thought. Yes. And I was going to be like, wow.
Good.
For that to be the title track, it makes sense. This is more of a party song, though, which I didn't expect. Yes. It's still about the girl, though. It's still about the girl.
Yeah,
I want to stay up all night and find a girl and tell her she's the one. Yeah. So it's still, it kind of in essence, what I'm talking about. I have to listen to the rest of the album to see how I feel about that being a title track, though.
Okay.
I'm not sure how I feel about that yet.
I think it's a good title track so far. But like you said, I think listening to the rest of the album will definitely help make that a more concrete decision.
Like, I'm not sure if it's one of my favorites yet. Because my mind was expecting something else.
Yeah, for sure.
But it's definitely got that up all night. Hey, like, I like that part. Yeah. It feels cohesive to the rest of the album still.
Yeah.
So let's keep going. Let's see. Na, 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 na. Takes your hand. I die a little. Why can't you look at me like that?
Interesting, because that follows the story for more than this.
Another really good one.
I love that just as much as I like Gotta Be You. I like that. I remember that.
That's up there with More Than This for me.
Yeah. No, that was an amazing song. Oh my god, I remember that. The minute we hit the chorus, I said, fuck, I know this. Like,
I've never heard that one.
Jordan, that was a good song.
That one kind of touches a little bit on jealousy. But I see you dancing.
God,
and Jordan, now it's not like, I'm not saying anymore that it's just because you deserve better. No, I'm saying it because I want you.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? I am noticing that Liam, Zayn, and Harry got a lot of lead vocal on the album so far.
I mean, I'm really looking for Louis. Where is
Louis? Louis and Niall from me. I'm like, where y'all at? Where y'all at?
Where you guys at? I would like to hear them a little more.
A little bit more.
Yeah.
Yeah. I will say, okay, yeah. But you rush cut like knives as you break my heart again this time. Tell me I'm a screwed up mess. Tell me anything, but don't you say it's what you're missing, maybe. Tell me what you think, tell me a lie. Yeah, I like that. They're all killing it, and Louis could have shared that verse. I'm upset.
I don't understand why they're not.
I'm upset.
They're getting any shine. I don't want.
I'm upset.
That.
I want to hear.
Sing back up for a moment.
Everybody.
Yeah,
that's what I want. And well, there must have been a time. I was the reason for that smile. As you take what's left. Nice. that one too.
I do like that one. The chorus is the best thing about that song.
I agree. I love
that. The chorus is really, really strong. Listen. Yeah, I just think at this point I want to hear a little bit more of Niall and Louis.
But if you separate that aspect of it
from the song,
from the album, like if you just don't listen to the album, that's the song.
For the album,
I really like it.
No, I do. It is not my favorite so far, but the chorus. I will give a 10 out of 10 because that chorus is a phenomenal chorus.
I love how pop driven this album is though.
Now that you can have me, you suddenly want me. I slept on your doorstep, begging for one chance. Who do you think you are? Who do you think I am? You only want me 'cause I'm taken. You don't really want my heart. No, you just like to know you can. Girl, that's what you do best. You're impossible to resist. Just a beautiful mistake. Who do you think you are? You only love to see me breaking. Thank you for showing me who you are underneath. No, think I'm doing this to make you jealous. And I know that you hate to hear this, but this is not about you anymore. You can have me. You suddenly want me.
So Liam comes back from the beginning. The songwriting on this album is interesting. Mm-hmm. It's that line for me, but this is not about you anymore. We've spent this whole album talking about this girl. And with every song, it's almost like they've never been able to have her. So for this song to be about how she only wants them when they're taken, it's almost like now you want to see. Almost like more than this. Now you want to see what I was talking about. Now you want to see what I've got to offer.
It's kind of flipped. I do really like that song.
Mm-hmm.
The tail end. So like
Zane's part
and Downward. I just felt the song really intensified.
Definitely.
And that's what I really like. Definitely. So I think that's my favorite part too. Yeah.
Hold on. Because this is very different. I feel like this chorus is about to hit.
Yeah, I'm very interested.
This chorus is about to hit. Go. I know this.
I want, but you want accessories, got to hold it
the
in.
The little rocking
voice. If I change the world for you, I bet you wouldn't have a clue. That's crazy. I want, but that's not me.
Ooh, come on.
I didn't think that's what the song was gonna be about, but it plays off of Taken very well.
Do you think when they say, I want to be loved by you, that's them speaking to her?
No, she's saying...
Is she though? Because if she's a gold digger, and she only wants the accessories and stuff, it's almost like they're saying, instead of you only wanting that from me, the accessories and all that,
No, no, she's saying, I want to be loved by you. Because he said, if you knew what you put me through, would you want me to love you too?
I don't know. I take it as them saying, all you want from me is diamonds, rings, jewelry, accessories, whatever.
Right.
And all I want from you is love.
Right.
That's how I took it. You guys tell us. You guys tell us what that means. I don't know.
I think it can go both ways.
You know I've always got your back, girl, so let me be the one you come running to on the other side of the world. It don't matter, I'll be there in two, I'll be there in two. It's everything about you, 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 everything that you do, do, do. From the way that we touch, baby, it's everything about you, 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 the way you make it feel new.
Well, I'm gonna come around.
Yes, I like the way you smile with your eyes. Other guys see it, but don't realize that it's my love.
I don't know why, but that reminds me of a Pitbull song. We got some Niall content.
We did.
We got some Louis content.
So I am pleased. I do like that song.
I do too.
I can tell by this point on the album that we're slowing down. I have to say, I'm gonna give that song its flowers.
I found the topic to be interesting too. It's like, I Want is a song where they're talking about how it's all about what she wants.
Yeah.
And so to say everything about you, I don't know, it's like they have a song about how it's all about her and then sing a song where it's all about her. It may not be about the same exact girl. It's probably a different relationship.
I couldn't stop the yawn.
So I don't know. Like we said, the songwriting's really interesting how they're kind of bouncing back and forth. But I like the common thread. It makes it an easier listen.
Yeah.
Favorites that might be up there for me.
Wow, no, that
I like this one too. I think that the first line kind of sums this one up. Circles, we're going in circles.
For me, that actually sums up the whole
album,
the whole 10 songs.
Really?
The first 10 songs. They keep making the same mistakes. They keep falling for the same trick.
Mm-hmm.
And
most importantly, it's like the blaming each other but never getting to the root of the problem.
Exactly. And like they said, when something's broken and you claim there's nothing to fix.
Yeah.
So that is definitely an album highlight for me. You play the same game and you think the outcome is going to be different.
Right.
So
right. Or you're addicted to that same game.
Yeah.
And you don't want a different outcome until the game ends.
True.
You know, or it gets too bad to where you can't continue.
True.
I want a savior.
I know this song. I know this song. Yeah.
It's a cut of three, can't sleep at all. And he wouldn't take it. You should open your eyes, but they stay closed. I want a savior, want a savior, heart to
one thing of help.
And that's that that's still in the recording. But they were, yeah. They were.
Did you hold in back those tears? Tears. I want a savior. He'll only break a little torn apart. Oh, I want a savior, savior, savior. Tonight I'm an away.
Yes. I wish they slowed it down.
Yeah.
But I really do love this chorus.
I do too.
And I like how strong Niall, Louie, and Zayn come in singing it.
Exactly.
And then they all come in behind them. The reason why I like to hear them all sing, and I think it's an obvious reason, is because you get five different voices.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's One Direction. All five voices. Another great pop dance track.
Yeah.
That was great.
It was a blend of all of their voices.
Mm-hmm.
And I really appreciate that. That chorus is spectacular.
It is. It's the...
That chorus, yeah. Good.
And to start the song off with that, it's such a big moment.
I don't really have much to say about that song. I think the message is quite clear.
Quite clear. You want to take her out of a situation that is just...
It's just not good
not
for her.
Not good for her.
Really nice song.
Okay, Teo Cruz. Yeah, this was a time. Different.
Don't you know all night I've been waiting for a girl like you to come around. I never liked the night. Turn around.
I know this one.
You stole my heart. Just one look. Take a minute, girl. Steal my heart tonight.
Been waiting for a girl like you. Is this reminiscent at all of Up All Night? Back to this like party note, party scene. That kind of ties this album together with the title track. It kind of ties it together.
Yes, but I also think it opens up either the deluxe, like the additional songs, or
another
album.
Ooh, I kind of got the same feel too.
Yeah.
Okay.
The song itself, though.
I think we could have ended at Save You Tonight. It's not because the song's not good.
I like it. The best part is the chorus.
Definitely.
The verses are forgettable. I hate to say it.
Just a little bit.
I hate to say it.
A wee bit.
It is definitely a good last party track.
I think that it works because it complements the title track.
Yes.
And it goes out on a high note. But I'm being a little bit biased.
Right.
With Save You Tonight. Because I don't understand why this is the last song on the standard, but not every...
But he's on it. And of course, you know, we're going to keep listening.
Obviously.
I just... This would have been a really nice song to hear all of their voices,
yeah.
And I wish I did. That's
like,
why
I'm just wondering
that the bridge and chorus are my favorite because they add a little bit of life to the song.
They do.
But I don't hate it.
I mean, we're only talking about this now because...
This is definitely the end of the standard.
It's technically the end of the standard, but I'm just like, I feel like you know, Zayn, Liam, and Harry have been carrying. They really have been. Yeah. All of their vocal moments have been great, and I've been enjoying it. The songs have been great. But did something happen?
I feel like
the balance is off.
And now I've really been absent for the album. And that's not to say that they make or break the album.
It's but just, they add to it.
They add to it.
It's a group.
And then we're going to keep listening. But for the song itself, I love certain aspects about it.
Yeah.
I'm curious to see how these additional songs are going to wrap this project up.
Definitely.
Sorry, it's corny. It's corny in a cute way.
They're robbing her heart.
Yeah, so it's a stand-up.
I thought it was stick-up. This is a stick-up. I think I was getting into the beats where I wasn't realizing what exactly what they were
talking about, yeah.
Okay.
Okay. I'll be there.
They lost me in the first half.
Yeah, no, I'm sorry. The first half, and I think I hate to say corny. I just, the lyrics were a little cheesy.
I didn't care for the lyrical
content.
At first.
Bridge and Onward.
It put it all into perspective.
That was, like you said, very ingenious. That was
smart. And I'm only here because you stole my heart. That was an interesting concept. Loved the chorus. I loved the bridge.
I'm a thief.
The bridge was very good.
That stood out a lot.
Okay.
Yeah.
I see what they did. That was like pretty ingenious, actually.
Yeah.
Shut the door. Turn the light off. I wanna be with you. Heartbeats harder. Time escapes me. It makes this harder.
Wow.
If we could only have this. Judgment's clouded.
I like this melody.
Night sky.
That's pretty too.
Try to scream out my lungs. Makes this harder. And the tears stream down my face.
Wow. There's emotion in that. Okay, so we had a little crescendo out. It feels like there's something more to that. Like, it's the before you leave me today. Almost coming across as, like, something inevitable. like literally losing somebody.
Or just
like, and I'm looking at Zane's bridge too. It's like that seems like childhood. It says here that the song deals with the grief of a partner experiences
after the suicide of their loved one.
And how they meet the same fate at the end.
Oh, because he was jumping off the edge. Wow.
Damn.
And Ed Sheeran wrote it.
Oh, wow. That's a little dark.
But that made it that much
more. Because it was a really good song. I actually really enjoyed that one. It's probably one of my favorites.
Me too.
Wow.
Wow.
That was packed with emotion. Okay.
Okay. Wow, what a switch.
It's not me, it's not you, there's a reason. It's like a stone on fire, can you feel it? Words will be just words till you bring them to life. I live to work, I'll never stop. You know I'll take it to another world.
That one I could see myself fist pumping to.
Yeah, I actually genuinely enjoyed that.
I like that we're seeing some more solos.
Yes, that was a good solos blend. Are coming in. That was a good blend of everybody.
So far, it's been, yeah.
That's actually a really big highlight for me.
Another World?
I really liked Another World.
Could see that.
Very good song.
Basically just saying, you know, me lifting you up.
Yeah, like
maybe
like,
giving you a more positive world is basically me taking you to another world. A more positive experience.
Yeah,
I
see more of like
being treated better.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? That's like I'm taking you away from what you're used to.
Yes.
Which is more than likely the opposite of that.
Yeah, that's how I take it.
All the High School Musical.
We've got a bit of love, hey. Then I'm calling back, begging you to stay.
Okay, nice. Guitar too.
We're like,
you know what that kind of music reminds me of? You know how in movies how you see like teenagers, like just, it's gonna look cringy, but dancing around the room like this? With headphones on?
Yeah.
The parents come knocking. Sit down!
It's loud. You know? I actually really like the verses. The verses, I like the melody.
Same.
That Liam used.
Same mistakes.
Ah,
okay. Reminds me of that one.
I keep playing inside my head. All that you said to me, this wasn't just a dream. You were right here, and I should have taken a chance. But I got
Okay, I like how they took that out. I like how they took that out, too.
I like how they ended that.
So, okay, I Should Have Kissed You. I think that that's a good finale song, honestly. Yeah. Like, that was a good way to take it out. Directioners, y'all were fed. That's a lot of songs. They give y'all a lot of songs.
That is a lot of songs.
Like, y'all have a lot to choose from. And it's nice because everyone's got such a different taste, different palette.
Yeah.
So there's something for everybody in this album, but overall, it's a good defining moment for their career and sound,
for the
especially
song.
During this time for a debut.
I think the song is really good as a finale. It does kind of tie the album up nicely, and I really like the way that they ended it, so that was a big highlight for me. I liked how they were sharing and going back and forth.
Sharing little parts,
on the verses. We were looking at their whole discography. The amount of deluxe editions, yearbooks, souvenir, like... You guys, they gave a lot of music.
Truly. But that's good for us.
Yeah,
that gives us
good.
A lot to dig into.
A lot to dig into.
Yeah, and I'm excited to, honestly. I think that we're going to see that progression in songwriting and sound, even in, you know, their voices maturing.
Becoming, you know, individual.
So I'm happy to see that. But as for this album, you know, this is a great introduction into One Direction.
Absolutely,
you know,
absolutely.
This is their first.
We figured when we gave the poll that you guys would say to start with Up All Night.
Yeah.
I mean, like we said, why not start with the beginning? So the album as a whole, very well put together. A lot of highlights for me.
Definitely.
Those being Gotta Be You, More Than This, and I Wish. Those were some big highlights for me.
I agree with everything that you said. I don't want anyone thinking that I didn't enjoy the album because I did.
Yeah.
But for me, it is a big thing. Like, where's Niall and where's
Louis?
I don't know what happened with that. There could be a story with that. You guys can let us know. But I felt like I was only hearing the same three voices.
Yeah.
So it kind of feels less like a group.
And
effort,
more,
you know? And I mean, if we did hear them, they'd be kind of hidden in the choruses.
Or sharing.
But I gotta compliment Liam, Harry, and Zane.
And Zane.
I mean, I do. I feel like, you know, Zane was Mr. Bridgeman on this album.
Yeah,
he killed
I was noticing
every single
that they,
bridge.
They put him on almost all the bridges.
Definitely. And Liam sounded good starting every track.
He did.
And Harry would come together in those choruses.
I just wish he didn't start every track.
I think that that's the only thing. Yeah, aside from that, though, I'm excited. Like, I think we're just going to keep looking forward at this point.
As always, we'd love to know what you guys thought about the album. Let us know your top five down below in the comments.
If you enjoyed watching us react, remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Turn on those post notifications. That way you know when we upload. And we'll catch you guys on the next one. Especially the next One Direction video.